Hello, guys and gals, and welcome to another episode of Rune Words. So today we're going to be looking at a very interesting rune word because it is one that can be placed in any six-socketed weapon of any kind, bow or sword or axe or hammer or whatever it is. As long as it has six sockets, this recipe works. It is actually one that was bugged a long time ago. And believe it or not, it was a really, really ridiculous bug. So basically how it worked is if you put this recipe into an item and gave it the rune word, and then took the item and put it in the cube and used the Hell Rune and the Scroll of Town Portal to remove the rune word, the effects of the rune word stayed on the item. And then you could fill the sockets with other items and make it even more powerful. But after 1.08, this rune word actually sort of fell out of favor with the community, mainly because of more powerful rune words that came around at the time. But that's not to say that this rune word is no longer useful. And without further ado, let's get into the rune word. So the rune word is actually a very long one. It is the rune word Dole. Eld. Hell, Ist, Tyr, and Vex. Now, you'll notice that there's really not a whole lot of super expensive runes in this rune word. I feel like Ist and Vex are really the only runes in this rune word that could be considered expensive, and Vex is really the only one there that I would consider to be a high rune. Although Ist rune is a very valuable rune, don't get me wrong, I consider Ist to be kind of like a higher mid rune. It's a very nice rune, and I think a lot of people love to use the Ist rune for a myriad of things, but it is rather low on the scale by comparison to a Vex rune, which a Vex rune is essentially what one. How many Ists does it take to get to a Vex? If I was going to transmute up to a Vex, I would need what? Two Ists to make a Mal, right? So two Ists to make a Gull. Two Gulls to make a Vex. So we're talking about at least four. Now, this rune word does not really have any variation at all. It is always constant. So it is a level requirement of level 55 because of the Vex rune. We have two to all skills, so plus two to all skills, which is very nice to have on anything. We've got 20% increased attack speed, which is certainly better than nothing, although if I was a Zealer or something like that who depended on attack speed for my life, I might want something a little bit faster. Which is funny because if in the old days when you could bug this and remove the runes and you could probably fill it with shale runes and make a freaking 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 120% IAS sword. So we got 20% attack speed. We got 20% faster hit recovery, which is not something I normally see on weapons, but it's very nice to see. Faster hit recovery anyway. Faster hit recovery is always nice to have. It keeps you from getting those faster hit recovery stun locks. We've got 200% enhanced damage, and this is made in a superior weapon, so it says 215. So that's the maximum that this can roll, which is 215%. There is no variable on the ED, so finding a 15% superior will definitely cause you to have a little bit of extra damage. We also have 75% damage to undead, which functions as off-weapon ED, very similar to Might. However, it only works against undead. We've also got attack rating versus undead, which is the same, only works against undead. And we've got 11% mana stolen per hit, which is definitely nice to have on a weapon. And do keep in mind that this can be put in a bow as well, and that 11% mana steal would be very nice on the bow also. We have hits, blinds, target, plus 33, which is a rather large hits, blind, target amount. It's kind of hard to explain exactly how much that is, but if we look at another item that has hits, blinds, target, I'm pretty sure that the Coif of Glory has blinds, target, And the Coif of Glory is plus one, I believe. I believe it's just plus one. I want to... I can't... Not all of them say exactly how much they are. And this is kind of an issue, but hits blinds target 23. It's 33 is a rather large amount, and I think that's actually way higher than just about any other item that I've come across previous. It's just going to make sure that everything you hit is blinded, and they're going to be blinded for longer too, which is also an interesting thing there. So yeah, normally when you hit somebody with hit blinds target, it doesn't blind them for that long. It's like a temporary blind. This one's probably going to blind them for a lot longer. We'll test it out here in a minute. We also have hit causes monster to flee 25%, which may be something that you might not necessarily want on your character. It really depends on the kind of character that you're building. So, for instance, if you were to put this in a bow, hits blinds target, and hit causes monster to flee would be very advantageous. If you put this in a weapon, maybe not so much. So keep that in mind. We also have all resistances plus 75, which is an amazing amount of all resistances. It's the same amount as a freaking wizard spike, and is definitely going to come in handy for not only getting your resistances up, but also allowing you the freedom to choose other pieces of equipment that you might necessarily want to choose. You know, if you're restricted because, like, say for instance, you had to wear like a really heavy shield with all resistances, or maybe you have to have armor with all resistances, putting on something like this will free up those slots for other purposes, and you can maybe fit something else into your build. We also have plus 2 to mana after each kill, which of course is from the tier rune, but is certainly not something that I am sad about, because plus 2 to mana after each kill is great. Every time you make a kill, you just get 2 mana back. 30% magic find, which of course comes from the Ist rune, and we have negative 20% requirements, which of course comes from the Hell rune. So, you know, we're looking at a very powerful weapon here, which honestly to me seems like something that should be made in a bow. I didn't have a 6-socket bow laying around, so please forgive me. And it's just a powerful rune word. The problem with this rune word is that grief and last wish tend to kind of override it. And I think that's the real issue here. But as you can see here, the blind with plus 33 on it lasts for a really long time. So realistically, let's see if we can get a timer here. So 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, 4-1000, 5-1000, 6-1000, 7-1000. So about 7 seconds on a hell difficulty monster. That's actually a pretty long blind. I think 7 seconds is more than enough. And if you had any kind of attack which would hit multiple targets, like for instance multi-shot, and you blinded a whole lot of targets all at once, this actually seems like a really solid crowd control bow. If I was an Amazon, if I put this in an Amazon bow, the hits blinds target plus 33 used on multi-shot would hit all the cows at the same time, or strafe would hit most of the cows at the same time, and would do a pretty massive amount of blinding to pretty much all the targets around me, and would keep me relatively safe, because most monsters, when they're blinded, can only melee, and they can only melee if you walk within their melee range. So if you're standing outside of their melee range, you'll notice that blinded targets tend to be extremely easy to get around. For instance, this is a spike fiend, and as soon as he's blinded, he just stands there, and he does nothing. He can't fight back unless you walk within his melee range. If you walk within his melee range, then he fights you. But that's only because that's like, you're literally tickling his whiskers. Like, he's like, oh, you're right there. He's like, I gotcha!
Yes?
As long as you don't tickle his whiskers. Yeah, right. what do I think about this weapon? It's an interesting weapon. It's not very expensive. I feel like just the one Vex rune in there with the Ist is not like anywhere near as expensive, for instance, as a Grief or a Last Wish. Is it something that you would want to make ahead of other items? I don't know. It really depends on your character. I feel like this could be really useful in like a Grand Matron bow with +3 to skills. Like, for instance, if I was a TNT or Freezing Arrow Amazon, this could be a very interesting recipe for those particular characters. Because if you think about it, you got +3 on the Grand Matron bow, you got +2 to all skills, so that's +5 to all skills of your bow skills. You'd have the hit causes monster to flee and the blinds target, as well as the mana steal, which is very, very viable to a an elemental damage Zaun. And then the +2 to mana after each kill. There's also the resistances to take into account here. So Bozons tend to be very, very poor on resistances because they don't have the use of a shield. And having +75 to all resistances on a bow would be very, very powerful. And even though the physical damage on this bow is not insanely valuable, like it's not like the 400% from some other items, It doesn't really matter too much for a elemental damage boson. The elemental damage bosons are more concerned with attack speed, plus the skills, mana steal, and basically just keeping the monsters away from them so they can kill them. So all in all, looking at Silence, I feel like it's really made for bows. Despite the fact that it can be used in all weapons, I feel like that hit causes monster to flee would cause a lot of melee characters a little bit of strife. You could also technically just use this as a really awesome wizard spike. So I know it doesn't have any faster cast, so don't get me wrong. I know wizard spike has, 50% faster cast or some crazy number like that. And it has the 75 all res as well as some other effects, but Wizard Spike does not have plus to skills. So this is almost like a pseudo Wizard Spike for those characters who might not need faster cast. Like, for instance, if you were a Firewall Amazon, a Firewall Sorceress, the Firewall Sorceress doesn't necessarily need to stack faster cast, but would probably like some all resistances with his plus to skills. So this almost seems to me like a slightly superior spirit in situations where faster cast is not something that you need. So if I was a Firewall Sorceress, a Meteor Sorceress, perhaps even a Blizzard Sorceress, where faster cast is not my main priority, this actually seems like it might be a little bit better. However, when you compare Silence to something like Hoto, Hoto is +3 to skills. And it also has resistances on it, although not as much. So with a Hoto, we've got +3 with 40% faster cast and all resistances 30 to 40. So it's kind of like a much more resistant Hoto with one less plus to skill and no faster cast. I could see some very niche uses of this. If you were a very specific character who wanted the plus to skills and the resistances, but you didn't necessarily want the faster cast rate, and it's really going to come down to those characters who are mainly melee and ranged characters, or who are using a skill that has a really high delay. If you have a skill that has a really high delay, you're probably not going to care too much about losing a little bit of faster cast, especially when you make it up on other pieces of armor. But if you're one of those characters who has to hit a specific breakpoint, who has to hit that very specific, like 105 or whatever the breakpoint is that you're trying to hit, then yeah, you're probably not going to want to put this on because it doesn't have any faster cast. Kind of thinking about making one of these for my Boson now. If I can get my hands on a Vex rune. I've actually got my hands on quite a few Vex runes this season. And could be interesting to make this for a Boson. I'll have to get my hands on a 6-socket Grand Matron bow. I actually think I have a 6-socket Grand Matron bow. Now that I think about it, I know that I'm not trying to derail the entire like game here. But I was just thinking about this. On one of my characters, I actually think I have a 6-socket. Or not a 6-socket, but a superior Grand Matron bow with +3 to skills, which I could possibly use for that purpose. There it is, right there. +3 Grand Matron bow with 5% ED and 3 attack rating. Yeah, that would make an excellent Silence. I could socket that using the Larzik quest. which is the only way you can socket superior items, which would get 6 sockets, and I could use that for a silence. Not bad. All right, ladies and germs, I do appreciate you guys watching my videos, and as always, keep watching.